Hi guys, I'm Jordana from the Ontario Science Center. Today we're going to be playing a math and memory game that's super fun and really easy to play at home. So for this game, you will need some paper that's been cut up into small sections, and you will need a writing utensil to write on each of the cards. So today I'm going to be playing this game using multiplication, but this game can be played with any level of math, so you can make your math questions as simple or as complex as you'd like. I'm going to start by taking two of these cards, and on my first one, I'm going to write a multiplication expression. 2 times 6. So 2 times 6 equals 12. So on this second card that I have here, I want to write a different multiplication expression that also equals 12. I'm going to choose 3 times 4. Both equal 12, so they both equal the same number, which means that these are equivalent multiplication expressions. So in this game, these two go together. This is a match. Here is my set right here. Each of these cards has got a multiplication question on it, and what I'm gonna do is I've shuffled them all up, mixed them all around so the pairs are not next to each other anymore. And then I'm gonna lay them out on a flat surface, and I'm gonna lay them out in 3 rows of 4. There we go. And now it's time to play. So for my turn, I'm gonna flip over any 2 cards. 4 times 4, 10 times 2. So I know that 10 times 2 equals 20, and I know that 4 times 4 equals 16. So because they don't match, I flip them back over in their place. Now the key is with this game is you want to remember where you saw each expression, because maybe on my next turn I flipped over this one right here. This says 5 times 4, so I know that 5 times 4 equals 20. And hey, wait a minute, I'm pretty sure I just flipped over a card earlier that also equaled 20, and I think it was this card right here, 10 times 2. So because these cards equal the same number, these expressions are equivalent, which means that they match, and now I get to keep that match. So the game is played until all of the matches are collected. So if you're playing with a partner or with other players, you just take turns until all of the matches are collected and you see who has the most matches at the end. Or if you're playing this game by yourself, you can set a timer and see how long it takes you to collect all of the matches. So give it a try, let us know how you do, and make sure you're all staying well and staying healthy. Bye!